Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopschool.com. Thank you.
Storage, basically the storage volume or storage area of that storage is a particular bucket or container. So the related to structure, unstructured, semi-structured, NoSQL data and SQL level data also. It is is connected to our VM and connected to our app services and connected to our any analytics part, as well as Databricks, data lake and data structure part and internal structure of DevOps also. Okay. Just a moment. Just 1 second. Shall I break for five minutes? I take break for 5 minutes. Wait for an official call. Just I'll talk to you on just 5 minutes only.
No problem.
Okay. Just wait for 5 minutes. 5 minutes. No issue. Okay. Hello.
Yes.
Sorry for the delay.
Okay.
Starting with the storage account. How to create one? Just storage account. Screen is visible. Ajudos, able to see see my screen? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So standard, most of all the cases, general purpose, version 2 account and premium for additional latency integrated and DCDR connectivity and a geo redundant. So geo redundant storage, basically the two availability zone. So geo redundant is where a failover to there is a DC and DR. So is one storage account is created and in particular zone, that is in East US, and West US will be your geo redundant zone. Okay, that is the geo redundant zone, that is GRS and LRS, which locally that portion actually locally redundant storage and zone redundant storage and another geo zone redundant storage, JDR. So this is specifically failover. We have to create another failover part, another part. But in this course and this AZ-204, apart from 15% to 20%, that is for exam purpose and storage discussion part. So we will create the geo redundant by GRS and make the access data available, even regional unavailability. Okay, and make sure it will be on. Already exist. See, access transfer. Ah, yes.
View redundant. I didn't got. I didn't get actually.
View redundant. See. Basically, it's a common based of the availability zone based or geo based. Basically, say Central India or Central India and South India. So Central India is another data center, one data center, and South India is another data center. So this is under in one country. Okay, in one country, that is in locally redundant, and the geographically redundant, that is another part, that is part included to the failover part and the availability zone purpose. Say East US is zone number one and zone number two West US, Central India and South India, South India and West India. So this is basically availability zone or zone based, or say a resource group zone. So step by step, but that is availability zone and availability set I have already discussed with you. So this is particular for only for recovery and failover and redundant purpose. Only failover purpose. If any regional data center will fail and will recover the data for through another data center. That is what geo and zone redundant part. And enable the blob public access to all people will access this public access. And I will discuss about the blob storage and data storage, page block and boot block. So blob storage basically binary large object storage, basically blob storage, and it stores some structure and unstructured data as well as semi structure, as well as video files, as well as other NoSQL data, and obviously through SQL data also SQL data also. So relational and non-relational both data, and as well as structured, unstructured, and semi-structured data. And security version 1.2, and data encryption. If we want data encryption, so this is another part to encrypt the data under storage. And the REST API call to another part, that is the REST API to app service connectivity, and another storage connectivity to multiple app service or any application programming interface to multiple structural data. So this is an advanced mode, and the security impact into as per the security center recommendation in Azure. Next, networking. So public endpoint through access to all network, no private endpoint. And data protection, enable data, enable soft delete, and number of days to retain deleted blobs in 7 days, and enable soft delete for containers, that is also on, enable soft delete for share on, and that is for 7 days only. If your data is deleted, so how many days will a particular data will retain for that particular blob storage, so or a blob container. So basically storage and blob is a binary large object. And basically, it's particular the data stored in a container. So that container in different model and different parts. So the container holds the total data and your file and uploaded structured data, as well as semi-structured data. So enable. So this the particular data protection part, and next tagging. Tag, as you know, all the resources only the storage account. We have to create the storage account part and no tag. Not give any particular tag name or other part, and the review and create a final running for final validation. Then another part is there is the two options are there. That is, one is access tier is hot, and another tier is cold. So hot tier means if you are access these particular storage frequently and day by day, we have to select hot access tier. Day by day access, every day access. If you create an archive storage, then we create one cold mode, hot and cold, two modes. Sorry, these options will be available here. Geo redundant. Next advance. Oh, by default that. Last screen already they are upgraded that particular screen. Hey, this one access tier is hot, frequently access data day to day use scenario, and cool infrequently accessed data and the backup signal like archive data or MIS data. We'll create in pool mode, that is the access tier pool, and hot is frequently data access. Okay. So next, networking, public endpoints, tag, and review it.
No, if I selected cool, but I'm using day to day, will it be what
is it will be working, but your pricing will be high. That is no problem. That as per your project requirement and as per your access, but the pricing will be higher than at least that is the cool part. Because your tire is lower and you are accessing frequently, that is data movement and data volume as per storage capacity, they are binded for that particular area and that particular project or archive mode purpose. But you use directly to archive mode to hot mode. So that is the main problem. Your pricing may be different. Otherwise, it will be accessible, no problem. All time, all day, no issue.
Okay.
The deployment is successful.
Yeah. One more thing is this data recovery.
Data recovery.
Data recovery. Can you go to that page?
Data recovery already is on. Data recovery. Geo-redundant data protection, object replication, blob inventory.
Yeah, the data protection.
Data protection.
Yeah, can you please click that one?
Just the one that screen I've already created. Public endpoint.
It was there in top, middle.
No. Just a moment. The migration.
Down is there. Yeah, under data management. Yes, second one.
And then data protection. Yes, enable operational backup with backup.
Yeah.
Already soft delete. I have already enabled it, soft delete, and soft delete for containers also. Soft delete for blob and soft delete for containers also. So
I didn't get these options actually. What is this for?
Which part, blob?
No. For all these operational backup. Backup.
Operational backup. Day by day backup. That is operational backup. Day by day backup through Azure backup. This is your day by day backup. That is Azure backup. This is your backup. Already backup. Backup center, backup item, backup hall. This is your backup and create one. If you create some backup, some Azure virtual machine, Azure storage, Azure Databricks, blobs, all are there. Your backup.
Yeah, no. Yeah. If you go to that screen, earlier screen, in that already that option is there. If I click that one,
option is there.
Often no need to do manually other time, right?
If you configure through that portion, so that you have to configure through Azure backup, that they are mentioned here. See here the data protection. If you just enable it, if you select a backup vault, no vault is created. Add a new vault, then backup would be stored that under in backup vault. After creation of backup vault, you have to create one backup policy. How long your backup is stored in Azure, that you have to check as per your organization policy and the client requirement, both.
Yeah, no, there is so many options in the backup. Which one to select actually? How I will know?
Which part?
Here there are many options for enabling the backup things, right?
Enable backup only for selective vault and the backup policy, nothing.
I'm asking in logical way ki how I will know that I have to select which option.
That is your incremental backup or blob storage default backup. if you disable this option, that is no issue. Already Azure will take care of the complete backup options. That is no problem. Encryption key only you have to on encryption. Backup Azure will take care.
No, that is.
Otherwise, you have to create one backup vault and please mention your backup policy and retention period. That's all.
Yeah, but if Azure is already taking backup by default, then this option should not be here, right?
No, this is for only recovery purpose. Recovery purpose and creating backup vault. Backup vault is a completely different architecture and different structure. It is a part of admin part. As per the application team and application portion, only storage account you have to create. You have to map the storage key to your application or access key level. That's all. But apart from storage and backup, our admin team will take care.
Okay. So this Azure backup is Azure internal backup.
Not part of this course. AZ-204 and any application level part is application backup. Any other backup. Application oriented backup that already taken care by Microsoft. It's a PaaS model and it's a completely on Microsoft managed service.
Okay.
And this portion related to IaaS portion, and because I show this because you have to link up this API to storage account and access key given to that particular application API. So that is after that you will get the complete space and total connectivity through API and app service. That is why I am showing this portion of it.
Okay, no problem.
So if you see your total course structure here, only 15 to 20%. That means only overview and how to create it, and this complete portion related to IaaS part, not PaaS part, and whatever the requirements related to your course and your part, I'll show you definitely, no problem.
I got it. Currently we are just creating a storage account, that's it, right?
Just creating storage account on blob container, and then we will create the container, blob container. Just a moment. Only storage account. So how to create on blob container, how to upload your file, and how
actually
to...
No, actually what is happening is I am actually missing a lot of things in terms of the basic understanding of these developer courses. I frankly speak with you. What I'm happening is I'm not able to understand that. See, what we are doing now is what is going to be covered as part of the curriculum one by one, that I'm missing. Let's say key
one by one.
Whatever continuation you are having, that is fine. Mm-hmm. But my understanding is, let's say today we are starting with a storage account. Okay. Mm. So, but I'm not able to understand why this storage account is needed in Azure. How it will be applicable for the developer course.
That is why you have to understand and complete the total services are infra part also. In Azure, whatever application and other part, all are related to infra also. This 50-50 part. So in a normal course, any developer have to know the IaaS part also.
Correct.
Otherwise, you don't understand how to connect them and how to coupling them to each other.
Yeah. So just now, what we are doing
only 15 to 20%. That means only overview. You know what is storage account, what is blob storage, how to add a container, how to add a service, how to connect to access keys, and the storage part of and storage to API management. That's all. That is your portion only.
No, I got it. 15 to 20%, but within that 15 to 20% also, there are many. When I will go for the certification sample, I was checking. There are many questions which I was not able to understand at all. Sample.
Yeah, that is related to IaaS. Maybe any instance example in your hand.
Example
now?
In case of like. they are creating a .NET SQL code itself in the developer course, and they are asking it fit into which module or how to solve it, those things. That itself is I'm not able to understand how I'm going to pass that one if I will go only creating just normal steps.
Normal steps, actually, as per your course, it's a completely overview course. It is not a very deep dive. See, even in C
As an infrastructure level, it is not, it's just an overview. I got it. But as a developer level, this course is purely into development, right?
Purely to development.
So, correct, but we are not doing any development till now.
No. I'm
asking, we are not yet started any development training till now. Means we will start later.
No, actually, in this course, see, if you see your course curriculum, now is if you see these portions only in your part, are you able to see my screen? See, as your security 20 to 25%. Okay, see, develop solution to blob storage, move to blob storage between storage accounts and or only for containers for metadata, and how to upload it and SD and data archive and retention. That's all. API to SDK, and this portion is a big part. It's a completely Azure data engineer job. Cosmos DB block fund. Cosmos DB, it's a IIS part as well as PaaS part. It's a serverless and PaaS architecture. Perform operation on data. Cosmos DB is a huge part. One paper in particular Azure data factory or Azure data engineering part, Cosmos DB covered 25%. 25% of your data engineering part. So how I will show that total Cosmos DB here? It's a huge.
I'm not asking you to show the whole Cosmos DB part. I'm trying to explain you that 15 to 20%, I'm not going for the percentage. Okay, it is part of the develop Azure storage. There are two topic main section are there, that is one for Cosmos DB, second for Blob DB.
Blob storage. Okay.
Now let's say we are creating a storage account that is needed for both of them, correct?
Both.
Yes. Now if I go to first or this, let's say second blob one, I have to go through the move items from blob storage between storage account. Let's say I have to create two storage accounts, then I have to move between how to move them with the containers. Like set and retrieve. That we will go through. But as a developer perspective, how it is be useful with these course contents, that part I'm missing. I'm not able to get it.
That we have to see as a developer perspective. First, you have to see there are as a whole part. You have to know IS, you have to know PaaS. After that, you have to know the DevOps also. Otherwise, how can I one single course, a single course is nothing for the total requirement. Developer code is completely stored in Azure storage. Azure storage connected to, that is through API, and the separate service and service level architecture will show here. One by one. That is, this is all the service level architecture in PaaS and IIS model also. So this is all the service level architecture. This is not any development part. But it is a developer. I will not have in this particular 204 course. Nobody will show you the particular developer code development or any core development part. Is a completely different, but developer will do that is complete. We assume that the person will meet that particular training in new .NET or SDK. After that, we'll be layering this part to Azure as Azure layer part, and Azure Fascia part will show you how to develop, how to implement that development code in your hand. It is not our hand.
Can you tell me the third point of the blob storage? Perform operations on data by using appropriate SDK. How we will perform
SDK? That we mean SDK. SDK is as a Java. You knew the Java using the appropriate SDK on data wise.
Yeah, I mean to say, ki how you will show me in the training for this particular point.
I will show you the total architecture and how to connect the storage, connect the containers, and connect the internal part of this portion also. But SDK Java part, the options are there in our screen. Options are there. That is nothing is. I will show you the API connectivity management. Just a minute. See, events. This is on one particular containers. So first we have to show. First I'll show one by one to create one container. Name Ashu. Private no anonymous access. Container blob access or container anonymous to container blob access.
Yeah, I got it your point. Container we will go through that one later. I was just asking, we are going more into infrastructure level rather than any development level, but
no, it's a developer, complete developer. It is included. See, the term only is
including infra level, correct,
only part of operations of data. So if we are not creating any particular blob storage, so how can I show this particular move blob storage between storage account for containers, implement storage policies and data archive retention? How can I show you?
I didn't come again.
We have to create first the storage account and storage part, then internal storage structure and the storage copy and data movement part. Then we have to create the API to connect the data SDK part to perform content by using the appropriate SDK. So after the first we have to create storage account, then internal, what is blob, what is container, what is API connectivity, what is storage access key. After that you will know the total part of how to create API to SDK and the .NET part also. And between
that is what I'm asking.
Data movement between the storage. Data movement.
Just to know that. Developer, this course is definitely, I agree with you, ki it is content both infra and both the developer level also. Okay. Now to know that, we need to know the infra level also, that we are going through also. But what I mean to say is, we need to go through the developer level also, both infra and developer level.
In this course, 100% developer level. I'm sorry to say, I will not show any part development perspective and code level part to you.
But last time you said that you will show me one Hello World example for the web apps.
That is defined, but that is the containerized. That is containerized part. That is defined part. That part I'll show you.
No, I saw the samples of the AZ-204 questions. Normal samples. I have a doubt that there are many .NET language query based questions are there in this developer 204 courses. Earlier it was there 203, then they again created one more 204, which is the latest one with the developer course. Okay. So whatever they are creating, this Azure storage or this Azure web apps or Azure functions, they are creating through the command. They are not creating through the portal, because portal anyway is easy. That I was doing yesterday myself, before taking this course, I was doing already web apps and creating resource group, all those things. I have done before taking this course, I had done it.
Yes, but yes. I have already shared you the document and books. Documents and books, that particular books, that part.
Books. That's why I was asking
to power up total easy.
I was asking Bittu Kumar, I didn't get any books.
Already I shared the book to you, book to Bittu, and in this particular book, all commands as per your requirement to PowerShell command, not any web command.
It's okay. PowerShell command also. Let's say I want to create a Azure storage or a web apps. Rather than going to portal, I will just, as a developer, I will create through the command itself.
command itself. That already I shared bit to that particular book. Please open the book and share the screen.
To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $3.99 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Which book can you please tell me as particular?
This AZ-204 books. Just a moment. I'm opening the book.
Okay.
This book. Have you got this book?
Yeah. Here I'm able to see nothing but one Azure blob storage creation. That's it.
Blob storage?
These contents, whatever is showing here, is not there in the down.
Not there in the down.
Yeah. It directly starts with chapter 2, and it create only the storage account. That's it.
It's a complete,
but I don't see any web app function or whatever the content.
This is the Cosmos DB API example, that is .NET prepared and that is .CS.
Only DB.
Now Cosmos DB SQL API example already is available.
Correct. Only DB is there.
For
but other Only storage is there. Others are not available. No, if you go last, there is nothing after that. These are all related to DB storage.
Cosmos DB API. Cosmos DB SQL API databases, all are there. Cosmos DB storage procedure.
Then closed. This is the overall. This book is nothing but one storage account related stuff. There is no web apps, there is no function, there is no security. How to create web apps through Java or .NET or any one language also not available. How to deploy, how to containerize. All the contents, whatever showing, it is not there at all.
Okay, I'll recheck it again. Any other version will be available. And this is only for this exam reference. Okay, I'll send you. I'll send you later or tomorrow morning.
Then no problem. See, my only problem is with my main content is. I'm going to write a 204 certification. Okay. Now 20 certification will be done by me. That I agree. But whatever contained in the 204, all the courses which will be covered as part of 20 certification. As I know, Microsoft creates a certificate based on the content only. That's why the percentage 15 to 20% is there. 20 to 25% there. That is because that is related to how much percentage will be available for that certification 204 as part of that. Okay.
And that,
now come to your actual understanding of the concept that is based on the content, which is there in the top. These all contents like web apps, function, Azure storage, security, everything, etc. Those each points that is related to the actual understanding of the concept with the developer, how they will use it based on either .NET, Java, Python, whatever. Okay. Now Microsoft is mainly into .NET, so at least all the questions and what I see is that is related to .NET only. There is not a single Java. That is also I agree. But yeah, but all the many questions, sample questions are all related to .NET language coding they are doing, and they are asking, okay, this is the code. Now this code fits into which setup, Azure storage, how you will solution, how do you will do the solution.
So for that particular elaborate discussion and other part, you have to register with Microsoft and do the Microsoft direct course from them. Direct.
That if it is there, then
solution part, as per their solutioning part, and any many part, many subject oriented questions and many exhibit questions, and they establish their question from their site only. That is example or Microsoft, that is my Microsoft.com site only. And you have to check up whether the training for that part of
it. As per my understanding, I did this training to avoid those myself learning, because I don't have time because of that. I did this training only because of that I cannot do learn myself, because I don't have time to see the Microsoft training courses, and I will do myself research and do that. That is why I'm doing this training, to avoid those extra timing. Okay. Now, code level, as you said last time, that okay, Hello World plays, we will see later part, okay? For the Java or
okay, if that particular part,
I'm not asking for the complex query or complex any Java training or anything. I'm not asking for any complex query or web development. I'm just asking a simple Hello World page to be deployed in a web app page, so that Hello World page will come for that web app. Any language, .NET or Java or whatever, we can anything we can do one, because that definitely covers, because I saw many research based blogs and this even Microsoft site also training. There is at least one language is having a common example to deploy till web apps through Java or Python or .NET or anything.
Yeah,
but that's what I'm missing, because I'm not able to do any just I'm creating a web page, and this is by default giving me one URL, and I'm able to access that I did already before joining this course. I frankly speaking, that I already did before this course, creating a web page through Azure portal. But that creating also I can do through command also, plus one Java code to Hello World page also. I need to understand how the Hello World Java code or .NET code will be deployed to the web app.
Okay, so
that is actually the developer 204 course. Infrastructure lover is there, but little bit morely into development, correct? What I understand,
tomorrow definitely I'll show you that portion through AKS, Azure Kubernetes.
Okay.
Okay.
No. Let's continue this storage. If you let's say open this, just to be clarification, I already sent to Bittu Kumar also. What are the things are missing? If you go to little bit top and you come down, let be on same page both of us. If you go to the top, so what are the things are missing and what are covered? Okay, like IS solution, we have covered provisioning virtual machine that we saw. We created one virtual machine in Unix and one Windows. That's fine. Now after that, all those 4 points we have not gone through, because I asked you last time, you will do later.
Tomorrow I'll show you the container registry, and
that's why I'm keeping a track, otherwise we will lose it. So that's why I'm telling you now itself. After those first point, all these 4 points are missing. Okay, now come to Azure app service.
After this Azure container registry and
That's what you told me last time, but I'm just in phase. I'm just telling you what are pending and what are covered. So our first point is there, and all four are missing. In Azure app service, we create an Azure app service web. Fine. We did the diagnostic also. Deployed code a web app. I sent a mail also that one key. This one we did only to that, but later, as you said, you will do one Hello World page or containerized and code wise. Okay. Now, fourth point.
I will show you that total questionnaires part about container registry and instance.
I am having this conversation is just to be both of us in same page. So what is pending in this part is deploy code in a web app, code and containerized. We will see with Hello World something, whatever, for both container and code we later. Now configuring a web SSL and API settings, connection settings, that you showed to me last time, no issue. I have to try
also auto scaling also.
Yeah, auto scaling also we saw last time.
Scaling also I covered.
Only thing is SSL and API setting. I was asking how can I do from HTTP to HTTPS. That I will try myself, because I could not able to get time to get a page or something to make it SSL or something. I will try myself. If any issue, I'll let you know. Okay. But in this, mostly we covered web apps more, but only the third point, deploy code web app, code and containerized actual deployment is we have to see later, as you said last time. That is the only missing. Now, when I come to Azure function, we completely not started yet. And now
Azure functions after covered that there is continuous app deployment to Hello World, then we'll start Azure function, because after that you function add to that particular requirement to additional to Azure Kubernetes or any containerized app to write code in Azure functions.
No problem. But just to know that this all Azure function is we'll do later. Now to develop Azure storage, this we are starting with storage creation of account, but we have not yet created a blob or Cosmos based, correct?
No, we have already created one.
Just starting
blob container. Yes. This container is pertaining to and this is blob anonymous access only, container anonymous access to blobs both, that we select always the third option, because only blob we have read access to only blob only. The container anonymous read access to container and blob, that is both will cover the structure and unstructured data as well as the video files also. All container blob read anonymous request, client anonymous within the container by anonymous request to cannot immediately contain without storage within the storage account. So that we have to create first. Successfully created container.
Just 1 second. We started creating, just to refresh what we did. We started to create a storage account. Okay. And after that, we are trying to create a container.
Container.
Why is that?
So container actually especially storage related to that particular blob particular container to store that particular data, and container related to either blob or blob container or related to access based container and to a privilege based container. So container hold the total data part. And under this data part, we will store the blob part and as well as containerized part. So this container related to your, we have connected to your application part also, as well as particular data part also. See here, this is your container, and we have any file that is the storage part. We have add or this portion, any file. Just as a book. So upload this.
This create container from which option we did?
So this is your part. Containers and data storage part under data storage.
Okay, this is a must to create
data storage part. And under this part, we have uploaded this is the particular book and any containers and any particular structure and unstructured data, and that related to your application and your access level also. And this part we have access to through Active Directory access to your role and assignment, and the view your access to this portion service principal or any group, any app services, any container registry, data factory access level.
Yeah, no. This option is there for all the resources that I got.
All the resources access.
My question is that container. There are two containers, blob and Cosmos DB, right?
Yes. Now Cosmos is different. Cosmos account will be different. Cosmos and blob is completely different part. Cosmos account will create another part, that is Cosmos DB account. That is not related to this portion. This is a storage account only for normal storage account. If you want to create another Cosmos DB account, then cosmos DB, then completely different part of your cosmos DB. This is, you have to create one cosmos DB account. That is different part. See, these are screens and everything in the panel. This core SQL part that is related to API, .NET, JavaScript, your table structure, as your Cosmos DB with MongoDB API, Redmi and Cassandra. Different options.
No, this is API options.
API options. And you have to create through Cosmos DB through API only. And API is recommended for table structure and partition key based access.
Okay, no, I see. Actually, I'm missing something. What I'm asking is ki we created a storage account first.
That is normal storage, that is blob storage.
Now that container, why it is required for this storage account?
That is that particular container to access your data, and how data will stored under your container. Container is the itself is a data bucket. It's a data bucket or it's a file bucket.
Yes. Now that data we choose now as a blob storage, right?
As a blob storage, as a blob container. As a blob
this container. Is your own container or it's some other product?
No, own container. Blob storage, blob as your own container.
And we created a file uploading that. That I didn't understand.
Why
we did that? I didn't understand.
Actually, how your container will work and your code and your structured data. Say anything you will upload through your data or through your code in your particular container based access. Say in banking part, say your organization level, organization say, hey, Ashutosh, please do please access your please upload your data along with day by day activity through a blob container or through via code or directly uploaded to your particular container. So how can you upload this particular portion to in particular Azure blob container? So day by day activity data, and they're related to through your API or through your code.
Okay, I will ask in a simple way. I am having a code or which code retrieves some information from the some of the tables okay of the company,
some of the document.
So let's say there is a Java build code or .NET build code. It retrieves some of the employee information from the DB database. Now I want to upload it into the Azure platform. For that, how I will initiate first? Means I have to first create a storage account.
Storage account.
And then I have to create a container.
That storage account to your SDK through SDK code part, SDK code, and your DevOps API or directly your Java API under this storage account, and this storage access key covered with your under your code, this access storage access keys, and these keys I'll show you this portion. See access keys. So these access keys, that is connection string, it will hold under your code. That particular, this is access key. You have to mention in your code or in programming language to access this storage via these access keys, and you have to build up such a way that anything you covered in your code level or any particular access level, bucket level, or any document, data, structured data, you have to deploy through your access keys via your code. And there is two access keys, Q1 and Q2, one primary and secondary. If primary is failed or you have a, and you forgotten your ID, So that that is why second key is available for that particular to connect your stream.
No, that is related to how to access the DB
access the storage via code,
through SDK something, right? For this.
See.
No, what I am asking is, let's say I have to migrate this my DB from my company Oracle or something into Azure platform, which is having the employee information tables. How can I do this in Azure because through this scenario? I created a storage
account. That is completely different, but Azure migration is completely different, but already data migration option.
Let's say it's a wrong scenario again. Let's say completely new I am building in Azure directly without migration. So I'll create a storage account first.
Yes.
And how can I create those employee tables in a database?
Employee table, you have to upload your CSV file and other unstructured data to unstructured data through your storage. And you have to check up with your partition keys. And for data migration part, already that is the resource type. I'm already showing you this portion: Azure file, chain to local on-premises file, storage account file. That is the storage account file. This is some transparent scenario. Move to a new subscription, move to new region, move to arrange templates, upgrade to new account part. And browse data migration tools also, that is also easy copy or Azure PowerShell. That is also available, Azure CLI, Azure Data Factory, Storage Explorer. Another part is the REST API, SDK, DataVox Disk, DataVox Heavy, everything is under preview. All options are available. That is Azure Migration portion. That is all options are available.
Well, no, migration anyway, that is a different topic itself. I'm asking is this that I have to create a table, let's say, in this storage.
Yeah, that is table data storage. You have to create one data storage, one particular table. We have to create.
But for this, I need to create a storage account first, right? Mandatorily.
First storage account.
And then I have to directly create a table.
Yes, you can. If you're not creating any containers, that is defined, but you have directly create a table. Table name ASU. Is your table
okay? Oh, this so now table. How this table will be come into picture for this container?
That is different part.
Okay,
you have to upload your data first, that particular table formation, and we have to identify this through our partition key.
Yeah, so maybe I think partitioning is
partitioning most important. You have to upload your data through your partition key and even search your document DB as a document data through search your data through partition level also.
So that this container comes into under which level in this storage account?
Any level that container, file storage, cube storage,
I'm not getting why this storage account is required.
Storage account required to upload your data and upload your documents. Upload your document via code, via accessing.
Now, to access Microsoft Azure, I need to create a subscription first, right? And I need to have a account of in a Microsoft account first, and then I have to create a subscription, then I have to access, then I can access Microsoft Azure portal. That is one example where I can have to do that. Now, to create a DB or create a table, which one is needed first? The storage account is needed first?
No. If you want to create a database, you have to create either IIS based DB or a PaaS based DB. Either SQL DB that is Microsoft managed instance, that is DTU based or vCore based vCore based requirement. That is
completely. So anyway, IIS based we are not doing because that is infrastructure level. That Microsoft Azure will give automatically, but if I'm getting a plan for this developer level, and I'm trying to create a table. No, I just can you give me one example where this developer will use this storage account?
Basic thing that is your storage and your a particular managed purpose SQL DB is always available. SQL database, yeah. You have to create
this is a altogether separate resource itself, right?
Separate resource.
No, to create a SQL managed instance or SQL DB, we must have one storage account.
It is included storage account. It is included
or not? Account. It is not related to this.
No, this is already compute plus storage. It is 8 VCO 256 GB database, Azure and then backup
that,
storage also.
That is as per the Azure plans, right? List of plans.
As per the Azure plan.
But what I'm asking is, in this chapter, we are understanding the creating a storage account first, right? So my only understanding, I'm not able to get where I will use this storage account by creating this. After that, where I will use
it? To upload your data, upload your document DB, to upload your document and upload your API connectivity and through code-based data and the code-based data access. That is your code-based data access. And directly your data will store through via code and access key in particular storage. That is why I have already shown you.
Okay, it's just a virtual account creation to communicate with Azure via the developer code API. Is it so?
Code API, developer code API, and the developer code based storage access via access key.
So this storage account is not a actual any physical storage. It's a just a virtual account.
All storage here, all storage or any other account related to storage, all are object storage, not in physical storage. We are not using any physical storage.
Sorry. I meant to say all are object storage.
Object storage.
But this storage account itself, it's not an actual object storage, right? It's just
no. Storage account is a storage account. It's a pricing tier.
Correct.
It's a pricing tier.
So I mean to say this storage account is a virtual account. Means it's just a representative of the what the user is using through this storage account. Correct.
Correct.
Okay. Now through this storage account, I can create multiple containers and
multiple
table.
Containers, multiple tables.
Okay, that is what I was asking. The missing why we will use as a developer or as a company employee, why I will use this storage account? Why it is needed?
It is always needed for the API connectivity purpose as well as developer perspective as well as to upload the data and upload the document portion also and table portion also.
Okay.
So next part. So block container, metadata, and appropriate data archiving and storage policies and data archive. So another part is show the person to you. This is the IAM access level. Who will access this particular storage via Azure Active Directory? Active Directory we'll discuss later. We'll discuss later because this portion Azure storage. After that, security mode, Azure Active Directory will be there. Authenticate to Microsoft Identity platform and other. Portion signature part and as your key vault is different but key vault is security bucket to store the username password and especially the certificates as well as storage access key. This is called as your key vault to directly key to access this particular key vault. This is completely different but so this is user level access to get my role and how many users will access this portion and what will be their role assignment that will have to. This is completely administrator job to administrate total area and total functional area part. As a developer perspective, you can create your storage account as per your requirement and you can create your role, own role, and other role also as per your given role, specifically by a global admin or a application developer or any other role as per your role. See, select a role.
To get our channel membership, click on to the join button, select the 399 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Like owner, contributor, active backup operator, what kind of DevOps lab user, what kind of role, what kind of user you are. And this is a service principal group, app service group, what the container registry access, data factory access, this assigned one by one. According as per your email ID. Through your official email ID, you can configure your total role settlement under Azure Active Directory. Active Directory is a but user-based big bucket and secure bucket where you can store our user ID, password, domain name, as well as setup of user role and role-based access control through entire Azure ecosystem, as well as external identities and managed identities through additional external users also. So here IAM means identity and access management. So identity and access management, through we can access or we can provide the role to our many user as a group admin or any application developer or any particular provided role that your organization will provide to you as per your supervisor's approval. So that particular part we have to create here, and we have to download this role assignments part also and to document this portion, what kind of role you have given to this portion, step by step options. And this role will add the particular API access to, and which user access to this particular API, and the block container as well as table container and the table storage part also. And here,
this is there for all the resources, the common
all the resources access control, mainly for access control and role based access control.
Yeah, mostly administrative kind of
one, mostly administrative job. Mostly administrative. And here you have to check the access keys, and these access keys you have to copy paste through your code or your directly from repository via Azure DevOps or any .NET code or any .NET direct connectivity. That is T1 and T2. This is your part. To collect the code from access keys, storage access keys from this area, access keys, and to put that particular access key to your under your code level. Anything related to that upload or download or any storage part, that particular document or your related to that code level output, our output will process through under that particular storage account or particular blocks to block container or particular table storage. But this portion is security encryption. It is completely security access and security level. What kind of security security access provided in this portion and security center generated? This is completely defined part. This is security architect will do and security analyst will do security portion. And geo replication data protection, already I have shown you what kind of data protection in particular storage container, use delete blocks, each and everything. Static website, life cycle management. You can create one rule, and that rule will provide this portion part also, and enable or disable. That is completely optional. And monitoring your insights. You can store your logs, customized logs, number of transactions, how many it is through your workbooks and the playbooks also. This is all related to that particular containers or according to your storage structure and the diagnostic settings also here. This is all this portion related to monitoring portions, completely monitoring part. File properties, the table properties, API metrics, everything, queue properties. Okay.
Yeah. So we saw only one creating a storage account. Right? As per this course content, how much we covered this portion? If you go back to the
this portion, that is
started in that.
Blob storage, blob only blob storage account and container set receive properties of metadata and uploading the data. And you can create storage policies and data archive and retention. Already I have shown you that portion only. The data retention, that means your backup portions.
First point I am not getting.
First point means?
Move the items in.
As your storage?
No, the second one, blob. Blob first point.
This one?
Yeah, move first one.
Move in blob storage between storage account for container. This one. Move your data from the data migration portion from Azure blobs and browse your migration to and transfer single data through AZ copy, data migration using the Azure data copy. That is data movement library, data migration, this portion.
Yeah, but we have not gone through this, right?
No, that we have to create another part. That is the data factory defined part and data movement. I'm showing only the options are available here. Yes. As per environment, you have to
create a storage account, and what are the options?
Options are available. Yeah. And especially these are options, Azure file storage, data like Gen 2 is completely defined on premises file, you can migrate. The data movement one storage account to another storage account and data blobs and this movement data migration and movement library and data Azure data factory and data migration to AZ copy. Through AZ copy we can transfer the data, and I can already show you AZ copy to command line to data transfer. It is a blob file table, all you transfer the files to or data movement to AZ copy, Azure CLI data factory, lots of options are there. Azure total.
No, these options are there, but as part of this first point, which one we will do? Which one?
Which portion?
The move items in blob storage between storage accounts and container.
That is the move item. This portion is whatever your environment, whenever your environment will be ready, after that you can transfer your file that is Azure blob to. This is Azure data movement or particular data migration, AZ copy to move your data directly one to another portion, download AZ copy.
Yeah, we will see in the next class, right?
No, this is already example, already example purpose. Because AZ copy, how can I show the AZ copy?
What is AZ copy?
Hello? Hello. Ashu. Hello, Ashutosh.
Yes.
So AZ copy is a tool to copy the copy or move data to one storage to another storage or a particular another subscription based location based data copy. You can download the AZ copy under Azure Movement and then you move your data to another another storage account to your another subscription to another any other subscription also. It's a completely tool-based data movement. Or you can migrate the data. You can migrate the data to your Azure migration tools also.
No, but I didn't know. I'm not getting how you will do this in the Azure portal. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm able to hear now. Some in between connection is breaking.
So these all the
asking, how we will do this first point in the Azure portal.
EasyCopy, you can download the EasyCopy and transfer the data. It's a separate software. It's a separate software in Azure.
No, EasyCopy is one of the options from that.
One of the option. Yes. Options. A resource type you can under this blob storage and transfer serial migration.
You have not seen any one of
library. Them. Yes, see Azure migration, data migration, movement library.
I mean to say this point, any one of the example point, at least we can see in the portal, right? So that I will be able to understand.
I have to create another particular storage account to different subscription. So I have a single subscription. So how can I do basically one subscription owner? I have with subscription to subscription level transfer. I'll show you all the options are available. But in particular practical scenario, in particular project based scenario, so we have to deploy them.
No, options are one by one. Options I can see myself in this portal screen, but I don't know how to move them from in between storage accounts.
See, if your multiple subscriptions are available, then we'll try. Otherwise, how can I try?
Not otherwise, multiple. So we can possible. Create two storage account in one subscription. Is it not possible?
To multiple storage account, but one subscription. How to data move to only EasyCopy or EasyBlob? You can try. Try it today. You can try yourself in today in your subscription, and then we'll check. And then we'll discuss in tomorrow classes tomorrow.
Okay, let me go through those options. I have out, then I'll ask you.
Sure. Tomorrow okay. I'll show you your most valuable and most demanded, that is your AKS through how can you transfer your, that is for the hello world. After that we'll discuss discuss this portion. Okay.
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts. Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $399 plan and grow your skills immensely. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest. Thanks for watching.